I think this is you and me, my friend. Let's up the game here a little bit.
As long as they credit that it's Korean stuff.
Yeah, so that goes, it's interesting. It goes with kind of what she's saying, though. You know, like, if you credit it somehow.
안녕하세요, 원다입니다. 먹방은 이제 전 세계인이 사용하는 공식적인 고유명사가 됐습니다. 지난 10월 옥스퍼드 사전에도 올라갔으며 전 세계인들이 모두 먹방이라는 용어를 사용하죠. CNN은 한국에서 유행하기 시작한 먹방의 형태가 왜 전 세계로 확산되었는지 조명하며 먹방을 일종의 새로운 사회적 식사법이라고 정의했습니다. CNN은 먹방을 혼자서 식사하는 경우가 많은 현대인들이 외로움과 허전함을 달래는 수단이 되고 있다고 분석했는데요. 먹방이 단순한 흥미거리가 아니라 특이한 소통 방법으로 자리 잡고 있으며 그것을 통해 새로운 사회적 유대관계도 성립될 수 있다는 것이죠. 프랑스와 영국도 왜 사람들이 먹방에 열광하는지 분석했는데요. 프랑스에서는 타인의 식탐을 관음하는 일종의 푸드 포르노라고 지칭하며 인간 본연의 욕구를 해소하는 방식이라고 설명했습니다. 영국 주간지 이코노미스트는 장기적인 경제 침체로 사람들 사이에 퍼져있는 불안을 먹방이 위로해주기 때문이라고 분석했죠. 초기 먹방은 먹는 장면을 그대로 내보내는 형태였지만 이후 음식을 빨리 먹거나 많이 먹는 챌린지형, 음식을 평가하는 토크형 등 다양한 포맷이 등장했습니다. 현재는 음식의 비주얼과 소리에 집중하는 ASMR 먹방이 인기라고 합니다. 한국 먹방을 모방해 창작에 도전하는 해외 크리에이터들이 늘어났는데요. 특히 주목할 점은 해외 크리에이터들의 먹방에 한국 음식이 자주 등장한다는 것입니다. 대표 메뉴는 불닭볶음면, 핵불닭볶음면, 떡볶이, 라면, 김치 등 매운 음식들이거나 불고기, 잡채, 갈비, 김밥 등 한국의 대표 음식도 단골 메뉴로 등장합니다. 먹방 유행을 타고 한국 음식에 대한 세계인들의 관심도 높아지고 있다고 하는데요. 삼양식품은 먹방을 통해 불닭볶음면의 인지도가 높아지면서 지난 3년 사이 수출액이 6배나 늘었다고 발표했습니다. 국내보다 해외에서 더 많이 팔렸다고 하니 먹방에 자주 등장하는 한국 식품의 인지도가 해외에서 얼마나 높은지를 알 수 있습니다. 미국 펜실베니아 주립대의 샘 리차드 교수는 한국이 어떻게 음악, 드라마, 영화, 패션, 음식 등 모든 문화적인 부분에서 세상 사람들을 매료시키고 경제적 발전으로 이끌었는지 설명하기 위해 한국에서 시작되어 세계로 뻗어나간 먹방을 수업 중 시연했는데요. 먹방을 통해 평생 처음 한국 음식을 접한 나이지리아 학생이 젓가락 사용법을 배우게 되고 한국 음식에 흥미를 가지게 되는 등 실제 먹방이 세계에 미치고 있는 현상을 직접 눈으로 볼 수 있게 합니다. 지난 영상에 이어 해당 강의를 함께 보시죠.
They have something to think about. They have something to latch on to. And Korea has done that unlike any nation that I've ever seen. And so we're gonna talk about some of those things today.
Can you get a shot of that? That's not how you hold chopsticks, my friend. You're holding it too low. You got to back up here. Can you show him, bro?
Yeah.
All right. Can you do a crunch? Do you got something to crunch on? Bro, that's a crunchy thing, right?
Yeah.
Dude, can you crunch?
Yeah.
You got to crunch for it. Get a crunchy thing.
Yeah.
Give us a nice crunch. What do you got? What is that right there?
Korean fried chicken.
Dude. Boneless Korean fried chicken. All right. You gotta give us like the real nice crunchiness. Don't be shy. Come on, you got this. Come on, you got it. Yeah. Okay, Ogana, I think you're next, my friend. This is all mukbang. Dude, imagine doing this online with, well, you are doing it online, live, so there you go. You don't have to imagine. Dude, nice, nice, okay, good. Here we go. I heard that. All right. Pause for a minute. How's the food, though?
It's beautiful, man. These guys got some perfect food.
Yeah? Have you ever had Korean food?
No, I haven't, actually.
Yeah?
Where's
it? Did you guys give them the spicy stuff?
I don't think they brought spicy. Did you bring spicy?
Yeah, the chicken. Right? Grab a piece of that. Let's see if you can do it. Can you zero in on him? Dude, go ahead, my friend. You got it. You got it. Yeah. Look at how he's holding those chopsticks, right? Dude, you might as well just use two hands and stab it. No, go ahead. Go ahead. Yeah, you got it. You got it.
It's too low. It's too low. Yeah, it's too low. Bring it up.
Yeah, break it up.
Go like that.
There you go. Oh, yeah. Oh, come on, man. Come on.
Yeah,
come
it's
on.
Not going.
Okay. There you go. All right. Dude. All right. This is spicy, man.
No spices. It's like, yeah, like buffalo.
We'll keep eating. You got to eat the whole thing. You got to keep going. All right. Hey.
Kind of full.
You know, you can't be full, though. You have to eat everything.
All right.
I know. I mean, that's the nature of it. Oh, Ghana, you got to keep eating, right?
Yeah, I'm full and I can't even eat it. That's the next
Do people that do mukbang, do they gain a lot of weight? Like, what do they do?
I know some of them are on like a strict diet and they eat like one meal a day.
So you eat one meal a day, but it's 8 hours long.
No, it's not 8 hours long.
How long do people do mukbang? How long do they do this?
It varies, but could be like quick as 20 minutes to like an hour.
Yeah?
Yeah, or longer.
Because I remember one time in class when we were watching this person that was going on for like 2 or 3 hours or whatever. It's crazy. Yeah. How much money do people make?
A lot.
Just for eating?
Yep.
Like how much? What's the most you could make?
There's like no particular number because like they're streamers and people just donate money.
Yeah?
Yeah. So popular ones get like a lot of money, like a couple hundred K per video. And
a couple hundred thousand per video?
Yeah.
Like, for just this, like, you guys could earn $200,000 for just doing this?
And, like, they get, like, millions of views on YouTube, so they get, like, money on YouTube.
Bro, I think this is you and me, my friend. Let's up the game here a little bit.
이제 먹방은 해외에서 각광받는 한류 대표 상품으로 자리 잡았습니다. 미국 디지털 문화 전문 매체 와이어드는 먹방이 유튜브 주류 문화로 부상했다. 먹방은 국경 없는 문화 유전자다, 라며 700만 구독자를 보유한 오클리를 비롯해 트리샤 페이터스, 제임스 찰스, 매니 무아, 제프 스타, 셰인 도슨 등 스타 유튜버들이 먹방을 찍고 있다 라고 전했습니다. 샘 리처드 교수는 한국이 한국 문화를 세계로 내보내면서 전 세계가 한국의 문화를 마음껏 사용하고 향유할 수 있도록 적극적으로 허용하지만 중국처럼 한국 문화를 가지고 자신이 원조라고 우기는 경우는 절대 용납하지 않음을 질문과 대답을 통해 꼬집어냅니다. 함께 보시죠.
Are all these cultural phenomena in Korea that just take off and other cultures adapt and other cultures embrace and other cultures participate in a very similar way. Let me ask you, one of the conversations we have in the U.S. a lot is that it's questionable the extent to which we borrow from other people's cultures, right? And so the word that we use is appropriate. And so like, oh, you know, like, and minoritized groups in the United States are really sensitive about having their culture appropriated by somebody else, especially the dominant culture, i.e. white people, right? So really uncomfortable with that. But it seems to me that that's not really an issue with Koreans, right? Like, it's like, no, take the culture, do what you want with it. We're putting our culture out into the world. We want you to borrow from it. We want you to use it. We want you to take it. Am I right on that? Is this a conversation that people have at all?
Yeah, I think so.
What are Koreans saying about this?
They're saying okay, because they're making better.
Mm-hmm.
And then they're producting better things, so I guess it's okay.
Eric, do you have a thought on that?
I think Korean people, like the whole world, like it's like making Korea known to the world. So they have pride in that.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Like it's pride. So let me ask you, can I ask a black student here? This is a really big issue in the black community. Like this appropriation of culture and like, you know, taking culture and like, you know, because this is a thing that a lot of white people have had problems with, have gotten into trouble. Is there anybody, could anyone comment on that? Like how that is? Like I can take anything in black culture and just use it and do what I want with it. And like, I'm a white guy, but whatever, who cares? So how is that? I'm just curious.
And I just feel like it becomes appropriation, especially like when you look at the Black community, it's when you kind of don't credit it to that community. So like, for example, like Kim Kardashian had these braids, and I think she called them like Bo Derek braids, and everyone was like, what the? Those are tribal braids. Like, what do you do? Like, that's not, like, it's just to the point of, like, you can take what we use and what we've been doing for hundreds of years, but can't give us that credit, basically, or just, like, not even acknowledge us.
Yeah. So it's really about acknowledging. Can you all say something about that? Maybe, Sina, do you have a thought on that?
I think Koreans don't think that's the matter, like, producing our stuffs and then like spread it to the world. I don't think that's like a problem in Korea, because I think Koreans think that that's the way that we can show ourselves. And then as long as they credit that it's Korean stuff, then I think that's the another way that that could show us that this is Korea and this is our own culture. And I think that's the way to promote ourselves. So I think Koreans don't really think that that's like a problem.
Yeah, well, you know, Korea has this Ministry of Culture, Sport, and Tourism, right? It's like a division of, with a division of popular culture. The explicit goal is to push Korean culture out into the world. And when you push it out in the world, you want people to take it on, right? Yeah, so that goes, it's interesting. It goes with kind of what she's saying, though, you know, like if you credit it somehow.
비록 정확하게 중국의 문화 침탈을 지적한 건 아니지만, 그것이 한국과 심을 인정할 때라는 전제 조건을 한 번 더 강조함으로써 중국 문화 침탈 행태를 꼬집은 수업이었습니다. 중국의 문화 역사 침탈 조짐은 한국인들에게 반중 정서를 일으켜왔습니다. 중국의 중화사상과 수직적 중화질서의 추구, 주변 국가의 마찰에 대한 보복도 세계적 반중 정서를 키우고 있죠. 중국이 앞으로도 문화 공정을 앞세워 한국 문화를 흡수하려는 전략을 유지한다면 한국인들의 반중 정서는 더욱 거세질 것입니다. 여러분의 생각은 어떠신가요? 시청해주셔서 감사합니다. 원다였습니다.